window seats, not quite.
All right, let's get started. I'd like to welcome everybody to our board meeting tonight, and sorry, I forget to turn that on. Want to welcome everybody, good to see y'all, and we've got school started, ready to rock and roll, and we've got close to 41,000 students, so with that said, let's all rise, let's start with our pledges. Mr. Rush, if you'll lead us.
Sir.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I want to take this flag, I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one indivisible.
If you'll remain standing for a moment of silence, please. Thank you. You may be seated. Dr. Sconza, do we have any commendations, recognitions?
We do, Mr. President and trustees. Let me first note that the month of September, we start to get our super staffers identified as well as our stellar standouts. So the next month's meeting, both of those programs will be back on the agenda. Tonight we've got not only a number of really important commendations, recognizing all of our secondary teachers of the year, but also some special public introductions we want to make to the board as well, Mr. Sitton. So, but as always, we will start with our inspiring moment. And this month's inspiring moment highlights two of our really exceptional teachers, truly the best among the best. And you don't, at least in this guy's opinion, you don't get to be the best large school district in Texas. By the way, if you haven't heard, we are the best large school district in Texas. But you, in all seriousness, you don't get to be that unless you have extraordinarily high quality people serving children in classrooms. And that's what we're blessed to have in Omaha ISD. We're really excited about tonight's inspiring moment. So you're going to get up close and personal via our video to our two district teachers of the year, our elementary teacher of the year and our secondary teacher of the year. So Wenna, you will roll the tape.
First of all, when I started teaching, I was in a Title I school in Oklahoma City, and I knew every single day that I came to work, I was making a difference in those children's lives because I was the one constant, steady person who cared about them, who worked hard for them, who wanted to see the best for them, and I never, no matter whether they had a good day or a bad day, all the days in between, I was there for them, and they knew that. And that connection that we built through those years in that school, I was attached. I couldn't walk away from teaching at that point. I have taught second, and I went to first, and then a transitional first, and then kindergarten, and I never left kindergarten. And I think the reason I've stayed is we're the luckiest teachers of all grade levels, I believe, 100%, because no one else gets to see the amount of growth that we see from the minute they walk in the door, when they are not able to write their name, sometimes they're not even able to recognize their name or the letters of the alphabet, and by the time they leave here, they're not only reading, some of them are reading first and second grade levels, their parents call and say, I cannot believe how much reading is happening. We're driving down the street and they're reading the signs, we're sitting in a restaurant and they're reading the menu to me, and they're writing stories and they're adding details and the math that they can do. We see so much growth in kindergarten in this one year. I don't know how you can't be excited when you watch. You literally watch that child's light bulb turn on and they take off from there. It is amazing to be recognized. It's overwhelming, actually, the support and the encouragement and Actually, when I really think about it, it is an honor because honestly, I've always known that being an uncle was a great reward. If you're an uncle, you're in a great place. Being a green tree, you're in a great place. And to be recognized as elementary teacher of the year for such an impressive district has been a great honor. And it's something I take very seriously. I'm proud to do that, and I hope I do it well.
Totally humbled by the whole experience. It's a huge honor. Can't even begin to describe how honored I am to represent OYSD as Teacher of the Year. To me, teaching is just an opportunity every day to make a difference. You know, there's nothing like, you know, seeing the light bulb go on in a kid's head or seeing a kid just do something amazing and just the they have in themselves and then I have in the teacher. Words really can't describe what that feels like, seeing that in touch with this priceless opportunity. Everything.
As well too, is it like you get to call it a father figure and also a teacher? Because at school and you have any anything, give up you out with your problems. But here at least fly away, like mistakes, you know, always help you correct your mistakes and fix what you did wrong. The world can't get this fly.
He has this after school thing on Wednesdays, and sometimes if the tutors can't help me, I ask him and he would be able to answer. And instead of just like giving us the answer, he actually asks us questions and go in more in depth.
They teach me as much as I teach them. You know, every day I learn something new about myself, about them. But those kids, all of my students, really, they keep me going. Last year, I had a really special group of kids that I was lucky enough to be their teacher, sixth grade, seventh grade, and eighth grade. So I had to follow them up all the way through middle school. And at the end of their eighth grade year, they'd all written me a letter telling me, you know, how the added class was for them and, you know, just some personal words that they wrote to me telling them, you know, how much they care about me and, you know, what their time in my classroom meant. And so it's just a notebook full of letters from those students that they totally blew me away with it. I didn't know that they were going to do that, and they gave it to me on their last day. Here last year, and you know, I was pretty emotional because I've grown so attached to those kids, being their teacher for 3 years.
I think that he won the Teacher of the Year because, first of all, that he can help his students in many ways, with schoolwork and academics. For it was elected because most of them like work with them, but he did so help with it, and so even your personal problems and also not their family.
I mean, he's really great, like. You can just tell how much work puts into his classroom, and he's just like a special teacher.
I believe that I can tell him anything if I have a problem or something like that. I know that I can
tell him
to help him and not just
to help him. You can't put into words how awesome that is to see happening in the classroom. So you have teaching major responsibility, but permanent opportunity.
Quality professionals in our profession right here in OYSD. So I am going to ask Melissa Hayhurst, our assistant superintendent for middle. Oh, look at that. Good job, Melissa. I'm going to ask her to come to the podium. She's already there. Melissa is going to introduce our secondary teachers of the year, starting with our middle school teachers of the year. And Mr. Sitton, if you will join me up front.
So while Mr. Sitton and Dr. Sconzo are making their way to the front, each of us can remember a teacher who made the subject come alive, who inspired us to know more. They made us feel valued. They motivated us to work harder than we ever thought we could. For Humble ISD students, the teachers that are being honored tonight are those types of teachers. These outstanding men and women live on forever in their students' memories. For what they do in the classroom, has implications weeks, months, and even years later. Campus Teachers of the Year are annually selected by their colleagues at each school as role models of the teaching profession. We proudly recognize these Teachers of the Year for instilling the love of learning, inciting passion for their subject matter, and helping students discover that knowledge is not an end itself, but the means to an enjoyable and fulfilling life. It is an honor to introduce Humble ISD's Middle School Teachers of the Year for the 2015-16 school year. So as I read your name, if you will please come up to the front and remain at the front, correct? From Atascocita Middle School, Nancy Gold. We will give her plaque to her. From Creekwood Middle School, Melissa Allen. From Humble Middle School, Tiffany Walls. We will give her plaque to her as well. From Kingwood Middle School, Christy Wooten. John Bennett. John. here tonight, but we will obviously give some plaque to him. From Humble High School, Kelly Dent. From Kingwood High School, Frank Shooter.
Trustees, we're going to start a new tradition tonight, and that is we're going to take the first few board meetings of the new school year, and we're going to formally introduce you to new administrators to our district. Actually, either new to our district or new in their position this year. And tonight we'll do our elementary new administrators. So when I call you, if you would be kind enough to please stand and remain standing for just a couple of minutes. But first, it's my pleasure to introduce you to our new assistant principal at Whispering Pines Elementary, and that is Gail Paul. Gail, congratulations. And Gail is assuming her role as assistant principal at Whispering Pines from being, most recently, the reading alt at Hidden Hollow Elementary. So just kind of moving positions in the family, and I know Pat is just thrilled, Gail, to have you with her leading Whispering Pines. And Gail, is there anyone you have with you tonight that you would like to introduce? Gail, thank you. And we thank you for sharing Gail with us. Next, I want to introduce one of two new assistant principals at Fall Creek Elementary School. I know trustees have noticed that among other campuses, Fall Creek is kind of growing. And so this year, for the first time in its history, it will have two assistant principals. First, My honor to introduce you to Sloane Simmons. Sloane is already making Yvonne Stroud very happy at Fall Creek. And Sloane, we are thrilled you have made the move. Sloane most recently was our reading alt at Elm Grove Elementary. So Sloane, congratulations. And do you have anybody with you that you would like to introduce?
My husband, Lex.
Thank you and welcome. So the other new assistant principal at Fall Creek Elementary I'm happy to introduce is Natalie Wilkes. Natalie also has Yvonne smiling from ear to ear. And Natalie, we're thrilled that you have joined the leadership at Fall Creek most recently. Natalie was an alt at Greentree. Correct. So Natalie, congratulations. And I understand you're soloing it tonight.
I am. I didn't want to bring my three-year-old.
Thank you, Natalie. Also happy to introduce our new assistant principal at Elm Grove Elementary, and that is Cassie Pfeiffer. There's Cassie. Cassie, I know that that Donna is just thrilled to have you, and not that there's a trend going on here, but Cassie most recently has been our reading alt at Lakeshore Elementary. So Mrs. Morrison, you can take credit for that.
Thank you.
She can. And Natalie, Cassie, do you have anyone with you?
Yes, we're all going to be in club. My husband and my two boys,
James and Taylor. Oh, awesome. Congratulations. Really excited to introduce you to our new principal at Timbers Elementary, and that is Lucy Schultz. Lucy, welcome and congratulations. We are thrilled that she is on board. I knew from the moment that Timbers sort of weighed in at convocation that things were going very well at Timbers Elementary. As Lucy has assumed the leadership there. Most recently, Lucy served as an intermediate school principal at Splendora. Prior to that, she was a principal in Sanger ISD. We're thrilled she's with us now in Humble ISD. Lucy, do you have anyone with you?
I do. I have my entourage, and my husband Marcus, and my daughter Ashton, and son Cal.
Awesome. Thank you. Now, Lucy is doing a great job at Timbers, but I have to say in all candor, she was left a pretty amazing campus by the next individual I want to introduce as the new principal of Lakeshore Elementary, and that is Stephanie Coronado. Stephanie doesn't look it, but she is a veteran administrator in the Humble ISD family and has done a super job at Timbers and is off to a wonderful start at Lakeshore. Stephanie, have anyone with you to introduce?
I have my husband, Jason, and one of my sons, Ryan, and the other one's
at
baseball
practice. Well, thank you all for being here. Thanks, Stephanie. Thank you. Of course, Lakeshore is another one of our very large elementary schools, and we're happy to welcome to Lakeshore their new assistant principal, one of two assistant principals there. And that's Holly Stevens. Holly also doesn't look it, but she too is a veteran leader in our family and most recently was the assistant principal at Elm Grove, Illinois School, again now at Lakeshore. Holly, do you have anyone with you?
I have all of my boys.
Oh, wow.
My husband, Brandon, my oldest, Jack, Owen,
Wow. Thank you all so much for being here. And Holly, I now have a newfound respect for you. A lot of men in your life. Well, congratulations to all of our new elementary administrators. It really is thrilling to have them join our Humble ISD leadership family. And, you know, as much as sometimes change can be very difficult to a person, these are welcome changes to our family, and we wish you all a really super school year. Mr. Sitton? I'm done.
Fantastic. All right, that brings us to the next part. Oh, do we have any comments? Or no comments from the public? Okay, perfect. Sounds good. So we'll move on to comments from individual board members. Ms. Conrad is not with us tonight, as you can see. She's roughing it. She's in Hawaii. But she did check emails today. We did converse via email today. And she wanted to let you all know she was thinking about you all tonight. And she was willing to Skype in if she needed to. But I told her to go fishing and enjoy herself. So with that said, let's start over here with our parliamentarian, Mr. Heath Rushford.
Sure. Just briefly, for those of you that are still here, congratulations to the District Teachers of the Year for your schools. It's a pleasure to get to recognize everyone again today, specifically Bree and Kim on your overall District of the Year accomplishments. Congratulations. Those videos were awesome. It's just a small testament of what goes on in this district every single day. We know that up here. I was going to try to keep track of everyone's name that just got a new job, but I lost track of Cassie, I think, so I'll just congratulate everybody. I look forward to seeing what new things you guys bring to your new roles, and I know you guys will do great things. Other than that, welcome back to everybody. Time to continue on another strong year.
All right. Mr. Lopez.
Just to echo Mr. Russell's comment, congratulations to our teachers. It's great to recognize those who achieve great things, and you guys are certainly great. So we thank you for your work and what you do for the kids in our district. Also, welcome to your new jobs, new administrators. We thank you for your work as well, and we just look forward to really good and exciting and event free, I guess. So any surprises. But yeah, we're excited about the school year starting, and again, congratulations to everybody. Thanks.
Mr. Cunningham.
Thank you, Mr. President. I too want to say congratulations, especially to all of our teachers of the year. And I just got kind of choked up because I too got emotional right there, so that was real great. And I appreciate all the work that's been lost. You know, being the fact that my wife is a teacher, it holds a special place. And so teachers, I still go back from time to time and think about the teachers that have affected my life. And I still thank to my very first grade teacher, Ms. Tarrant, even though she used to use a ruler back then to make sure I didn't lose my reading. But I like what they call that there, that builds character. So I love that character. But wanted to say congratulations to all the administrators. I see my Fall Creek fans walked out. You'll see, there's Ms. Coronado right there. I still have the book and I'm almost finished. Thank you very much. And I wanted to say congratulations also to one of our board members. As I was reading in the Times here, out of 120 applicants, Ms. Angela Conrad was chosen for the leadership task, the new future leaders in the making. So. Never fear, after I step down, we will have somebody to follow my place. So that said, Mr. President, I'm through.
All right, thank you.
Welcome to the new school year, too.
Thank you.
Mr. Ringwald.
As you can see from the small abrasion on his forehead, his wife continues his first grade teacher's ruler to keep him in line.
Go ahead. I'm going to interrupt just for a second. Yes. I kept saying what till I finally learned how to say yes, ma'am.
I'll also welcome all the new principals, assistant principals, congratulate the teachers of the year. I want to say a special thank you to the lady on the front row here, who Mrs. Allen is the band director at Creek. As we've been fortunate to have her teach both of our daughters, our oldest daughter is now teaching French horn and my youngest, she's in eighth grade, it's in the honors band, plays flute. So it's just amazing how they've grown. And how you put together middle school kids and make them sound good. I've never understood that, but it's amazing. Amazing. Thank you, thank you.
All right, Ms. Morrison.
Well, I too want to say thank you to all those wonderful teachers that we had in the audience tonight. Congratulations. The reason why we're the greatest big district is because of you and many, many more. So hats off to you. And many good wishes to all those new administrators and the administrators that are brave enough to go to another spot. And I wish you the greatest year of all. Thank you.
All right. So my turn, and again, ditto, thanks to all the teachers. I was one of those at one point in time in my career, and you know, I still have to this day kids that are now grown coming up to me, hey coach, how you doing? Last year I was going around with the prize posse with the foundation and walked into Atascocita High School, and a female science teacher walked up behind me and she said, coach, you don't remember me, do you? And I turned around and it was April Lamb. I coached her when she was a freshman at Aldine High School. So, you know, it's amazing. You don't think that they're remembering you, but they do. And then as Mr. Cunningham was telling his story, I got to thinking about George Turner's wife, Miss Jane Turner. She was my senior English teacher. That was the hardest class I've ever had in my life. And I tell her every time I see her, you molded me. She goes, oh God, don't you tell me. So, well, welcome to the new school year. I know we don't have any schools that are overcrowded. I know that we don't have any temporary buildings out there, and we got room to grow. So thank you, and bless your heart, and take care of those kids. And the last comment I wanted to make, and I don't see her here, but I wanted to make a special thank you to our current CFO, Ms. Lynn Lynn. Tonight would have been her last board meeting with us. She's retiring at the end of the month. And, you know, we take a lot of credit at times when we tout that we have a balanced budget and that we have a surplus and that we had $155 million worth of bonds left over to help us start this new expansion, this new building program that we're embarking on right now. Six schools in 8 years, starting in 2016. But Ms. Lynn has played a huge, huge role in our fiscal responsibility and where we're at today. 3 years in a row with balanced budgets. She went through the 2011 crisis right there with us, helping us make those cuts, but not cutting programs, just readjusting the budget. So again, I wish she was here so I could thank her personally, but she will be missed, and I think I'll stop right there. So Dr. Sconso?
No report, Mr. City.
All right. Let's move on. Mr. Rushing, do we have any motions for closed session?
Yes, Mr. President. As to the personnel, I move that the board approve the administration's personnel recommendations as presented with the addendum.
We have a motion.
Second.
We have a second. All those in favor? 6-0. What about to the minutes?
As to the minutes, I move that the board approve the minutes for the regular board meeting held on August 11th, 2015.
We have a motion.
Second.
We have a second. All those in favor? 6-0.
And as to the minutes, I move that the board approve the minutes for the special meeting and workshop held on August 18th of 2015.
We have a motion.
Second.
And we have a second. All those in favor? 6-0. All right, let's move on to our committees. Audit committee. Mr. Cunningham.
Yes, Mr. President. Board members, you have before you a report for the activities, audit activities for August. If you have any questions, please get with any committee member, Mr. Rushing, Mr. Malagi, myself, or with Ms. LaShawn if you have any questions. And that's all. You should have gotten yours too, Mr.
Yes,
President.
Yeah, I got it earlier today.
All right.
And I'm going to say this. I didn't realize how hard Sean worked. I'm getting too many emails. Lord have mercy. So, all right, board and superintendent evaluation process and goals. Angela's not here. Keith, do you have?
Sure. We will have a discussion about the goals board evaluation on the 19th of this month. And so we'll be able to hopefully get that process finished up and close to being finished at that time.
Okay. Building and planning, Mr. Engelhardt.
Yes, sir, Mr. President. As you know, we had a lively meeting last week. A few items that the board might be interested in. The land purchase negotiations are almost complete for the high school, 155 acres. That should be done in another week or two. That's still on the correct plan. Did you have a meeting with the new developer on 29?
Tomorrow.
Meeting tomorrow with the new developer. We're trying to get some land, 15 acres for elementary 29. We had a very entertaining and lively discussion with TDK about elementary school number 28. Did a beautiful job. I think you all have that from them for the design development. So we'll discuss that a bit later. The RFQ has been released for the facility assessment, and that should be something that comes to the board in November.
Right.
So that's good. And last but not least, our good friends at the Houston Sports Authority have given us $800,000 for additional parking at Turner Stadium, which is supposed to be done by next summer. November 11th. Any questions? That's it, Mr. President.
All right. So let's see. The Finance Committee, Mr. Rushing.
Yes, sir. I spoke with Dr. Sconzo today with the transition to CFO that you just referenced. Dr. Sconzo and I will be meeting with Ms. Lynn prior to her departure next week, at which time then we will all just kind of be brought up to speed with at least how things have run in the past. And then Dr. Sconzo and I will talk about a game plan in terms of bringing the committee back together with the new CFO.
Perfect. Education Foundation, Mr. Lopez, would you take that one for me?
Sure. This week, the Humble ISD Education Foundation is awarding $142,570 to Humble ISD schools and departments, which is half of the funds received from last year's employee campaign, which is awesome. 3 years ago, the foundation redesigned the employee campaign to include a promise to award half or 50% of donations received back to the donor's campus. These funds are to be used to support direct campus needs. The remaining 50% is used to fund innovative education grants in May. So the 50% was paid back to the schools this week. Since that promise 3 years ago, there has been a 55% increase in employee donations to the Education Foundation. Last year, the MBYSD employees pledged the largest amount ever at $310,000, and that's just amazing. As of June 30th, the foundation has received $285,141 in donations from employees and is on target to receive the full amount of the $310,000 pledged by September 30th, the last pay period before the new campaign begins on October 1st. I want to personally thank, and on behalf of the board as well, all of our Humble ISD employees for their continued support of the Education Foundation and the support of their students in our district. It's amazing to see employees give of their own money to give back to the students in their classrooms. It really is an amazing thing as just a member of this community to see that. We look forward to another record-breaking campaign this October. So again, thank you to all the employees that give to the Humble ISD Education Foundation. October 14th will be our district's annual Principal for a Day event, where community members get to serve as a guest principal and get an insider's view of the challenges and successes of our school's experience every day. If you'd like to serve as a guest principal at one of our schools, please contact Jerry Monbaron in our district's community development office. And I will say that, was it 13 years ago? I served as principal of the day, and it was at Creekwood Middle School, and it was a very interesting experience. lots of another story, but there was some shenanigans going on in the bathroom, and a toilet paper roll was lit on fire. And so Walt Winicky and myself became firemen, taking water from the sink and trying to put out, why we didn't grab a fire extinguisher, I don't know, and put out a toilet paper roll that was on fire. So we became firemen as well as principals for that day. Long story short, it was a wonderful experience, despite the little temporary, it was a small, tiny block fire. We made a much bigger deal of it than it really was. But it was a real, honestly, a great experience. You follow around the principal, you get to see what happens at day-to-day school. They're very generous with their time and their access. And if you want to see really how the sausage is made in the district, you follow the principal around for a day, and you'll see the amount of work they have to deal with and the day-to-day issues that go on, not staying fires in the bathroom. So yes, I highly recommend anybody that has not had a chance to participate in that to call Jerry and to try to be a part of that great event. And that's it.
All right, fantastic. Ms. Morrison, Kingwood Super Neighborhood Council.
Okay, before each committee, you have a purple folder, and so the Kingwood Area Super Neighborhood Council, inside the folder it has the items that were covered at the meeting, and it will give you the highlights and they're interested. Of course, they're always interested on North Park and widening it. So, and also it gives you the information on they have restructured their website, so it will give you the instructions on how to get there. So each board member has a submission. And legislative, would you like that report too?
Yeah, you're next.
Hey, I'm next too. Well, on the right-hand side of your purple folder, our committee has given you a summation of the 84th session. And Representative Huberty met with me, and we summated, and he gave us a summary of all the things that went on, and also gave the opportunity that if we should like for him to come and give us an update, he will be happy to come to any good meeting and do that. So, there we are.
All right. Program Evaluation Committee, Mr. LaPez.
No report for this meeting, sir.
Okay. And Technology and Data Governance Committee, anyone from the Technology Committee want to give a report or an update?
Sure, I'd be happy to. We met Tuesday of last week, I believe it was. We're working basically in planning for the workshop that we have scheduled October 6th-ish. And so basically got a walkthrough of the three different goals that we have set forth in our technology plan for this year, and where we have come in relationship to accomplishing the goals from a percent perspective, from a money spent perspective, and look forward to updating the rest of the board on those activities.
All right. That takes care of our committee reports. So let's move on to the consent agenda. Everyone should have received this last Thursday or Friday. Friday. So you had all weekend to look it over. I'm sure if you had questions, got those answers. So let's move right on. Under governance considerations, item A, resolution to support variance of regulation. Consent. Under superintendent division reports, live streaming and video record school board meetings. Item A, that's consent. No reports, items under learning division. Financial services division, item A, tax refunds. Consent. Item B, removal of tax accounts from delinquent tax roll. Consent. Resale properties. Consent. Item D, budgetary amendments. Consent. Nothing under human resources. Under support services divisions. Item A, Harris County Public Health and Environmental Services interlocal agreement. That is consent. Elementary school number 28, design development. That is consent. Item C, construction and construction-related purchases. That is consent. Under district-wide reports, considerations and purchases, Item A, goods, professional services, and non-construction services exceeding $50,000 in the aggregate or $25,000 individually. That is also consent. Mr. Russian, could we get a motion?
Yes, sir. As to the consent agenda, I move that the board approve the following items by consent. Under governance, item A. Under superintendent's division, item A. Under financial services division, items A, B, C, and D. Under support services division, items A, B, and C. And under district-wide reports, considerations, and purchases, item A.
We have a motion.
I make a motion.
We have a second. All those in favor? 6-0. Dr. Scanzo?
Mr. Sutton, I appreciate you letting me just make a note. Thank you for approving the design development for elementary school number 28. It is a repeat of Rich Creek, as Mr. Englotti mentioned, and it has just proven to be just a phenomenal elementary school design for us. I want to recognize, many of you know her, Irene Negaglioni, all the way in the back of the room. Irene was our first ever lead architect when we embarked on our first project at Texas City High School with PBK Architects. And with all due respect to the many wonderful architects that we have worked with over the years, they don't come better than Irene. Unfortunately, a few years ago, PBK decided she needed to take over their Dallas office. So we've not worked directly with her since, but Irene, it's great to have you with us tonight, and thank you.
Is this costing us extra to have Irene?
Now, it is an absolute treat to be here tonight. Thank you.
Thanks, Alderman. Right. Thank you. Okay, under governance reports, we have the TASB policy update 102 for your information, and also the proposed revisions to policy CNB local. So if you have any questions on that, Dr. Sconzo can answer those. But these are informational items, look it over. And if you have some questions, just let us know on that. Okay, then under financial services, we have our report on delinquent tax collections for the period July 1, 2014 through June 30, 2015.
President Sutton and trustees, it is that time of year to receive our annual report from our delinquent tax law firm, Purdue, Brandon, et cetera, et cetera. One of our very own patrons leads all of the delinquent accounts collections for us, and that's Attorney Greg East, who is at the podium now to make the presentation. And Greg, before I set you loose, I do want to recognize Janice Himple in the audience tonight. Janice is our tax collector, and actually Greg doesn't get a whole lot of business because Janice does a great job. Uh-huh. Janice, thank you very much. Greg.
All right, thank you. Usually I'll be here with Donnie Roseman. He had to go to our McAllen office for a couple days. I'm sure I can say he would rather be here, but we had a long drive to McAllen. So the first slide is just a reminder of how the tax system works in Texas. In October, your tax office mailed the 2014 tax bills. You have a couple months of time, and then February 1st, they go delinquent. Penalties interest start from being charged in. There's a 6% penalty that increases up to a maximum of 12 by July. And there's interest of 1% per month until it's paid. In May, the tax office sends a notice that the collection penalty will be added on if you don't pay by June 30th. And if people haven't paid on July 1st, the tax year 2014 gets turned over to us. This is a look at your entire tax levy. Levied over $190 million for the 2014 tax year, and you've collected before by June 30th, $187 million. You just have a few million left out of the whole And this is showing just the history of your current year collection percentage by June 30th. That's before we get any of it. You can see the last several years you've been at 98%. So when you finally give us what's left over, we take over July 1st. We immediately start analyzing the roll. We look for accounts that have peculiar addresses. We check to make sure the address is right. We look for foreclosures, that kind of thing. And we send out a mass mailing and start making phone calls in July. So the biggest portion that's under here is collection pending. That's just accounts that have nothing special. It's just a normal account that we're working on. That's nearly 70% of those turned over. And you can see some accounts in litigation already, about 11%. Accounts in partial payment agreements, about 5%. Accounts in deferral, it's 9%. At deferrals, you're allowed, the taxpayer's allowed to get, they're over 65 or have a disability. And taxes are still due, they're still delinquent, but the interest rate you can charge is less than normal. And we don't work on the account as long as the accounts are unsaid. This shows status quo for all years. There's always going to be some back years due. We keep working on those. And so the biggest support for social collection pending is most of that's 2014. And it's the bankruptcy account deferral you have is over $1 million, about 17% of the entire delinquent roll. And the other sections aren't showing up in this version of PowerPoint. You can see on your page that those are litigations over 20% and some other various codes at 11%. So nothing really unusual this year in this section. This shows how much is due, it's delinquent for all tax years, just year by year. Whereas the biggest portion is 2014 at 39%, and then half that 2013, and then just gets smaller as you go further back in time. This shows current year turnover. This shows how much is turned over to us each year, the last several years. You see it's declined a lot and then it's kind of stayed steady until this year went up a little bit. And for 2008, which is now off the chart, it was, I think, over $1 million, if I remember. So the turnover to us has been a lot less than. This shows our history of the first year of each tax year that's turned over to us. Each year is turned over to us in July. And one thing we look at is see how much we collected that first year. Because it's always easier to get taxes paid sooner rather than later. See, for the last year, for 2013, that we just finished June 30th, collected 69.98%. That's like $400-$500 away from 70%, which I looked up. A couple times, I'm not sure I was doing my math right, but that's what it was. And you see, it's a little bit higher in the last couple of years. Generally, for the first year, we want to be around 70%. And it's a lot less than usually is with some weird bankruptcy or something unusual like that. But here, we've been fortunate. We've been around 70% every year for a long time. So going back to the 2008, see, we started at 70%. Second year with up to 80. You see by the fifth year we're up to 90%. So the 2009 tax year, we originally started in July of 2010. Started around 71 and then get up to 90 by the fifth year. And the other charts are the similar tax years, basically all on the same path. And the last point, Donnie, that I wanted to make, I don't have a slide for it, is that we were looking at if since we're generally at 90% of the fifth year of collections, that means for 2014, we expect to have, we're about $2.6 million now, we'll have about $260,000 left in 5 years from now. So the original levy was $190 million. That means in 5 years, what you all have left is about 0.14% of what you originally levied last October. So that's pretty good. Of course, most of those put by the tax office where I got to do anything, but I think seniors 2012 and then 2013. So I'd like to thank the tax office. They are a huge help in making our job easier. Hopefully, on occasion, I make their job easier. That's probably as often as I should. But we do appreciate them a lot.
questions? Mr. Cunningham.
Thank you, Mr. President. Greg, I'm looking on page five, and this bad address is kind of catching me, kind of helping me understand. Is that properties that are probably owned out of the country, out of the state?
A lot of those would be people out overseas, and it'd be code bad address. We go through those and try to get the good address, and we send it with the proper postage. But they're code bad address just because that's how the year was out.
Okay.
So those accounts were just lots of years due, and the property is low value and just hasn't been a good address on them in years and years. We're periodically go through and look through those to look see if we can find something new. Because a lot of times it'll be if someone's moved or the property is foreclosed and that kind of thing. So we go through and work on what we can. A lot of those are, especially even with the internet and everything else, once people are overseas, it's really hard to find.
That's all I
had. Anyone else? All right, well, thank you very much. All right, appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
It's probably the strip. I know we've got some funky strips.
All right, so as he's packing up, the last informational item are our normal financial service reports. Tax collections, cash investments, revenues, expenditures, construction in progress.
Mr. President, would be happy to respond to any questions trustees may have, but nothing unusual in those reports.
Any questions, concerns? All right, anything that we need to look at for future board business? Not seeing any? We're done.